Let's go and continue on with finding wins here to make a little bit of money this season, betting on Vegas's lines for the overall win totals for every single team. So here we go. Let's restart here with the Lions. We left off on the Lions, so let's start here. So here we go. Their line, and this isn't even the lowest line we've seen. The Texans was 4. Now the Lions line for overall win totals is 4.5. Over 4.5 wins is minus 140. This is the favorite. And under 4.5 wins is plus 115. So Vegas is saying, hey, they're probably going to win over 4.5 games. Now, we don't really love this Lions team. Jared Goff is a little bit of a question mark. Dan Campbell, we really don't buy it all. But maybe their schedule is easy. They have a lot of easy opponents. There's not a lot of teams worse than the Lions overall, so it's really going to be hard for us to truly say definitely that this Lions team can win a couple of games. But let's go to their schedule and see if we can find the 4.5 wins needed to bet the over. So here we go. Week 1 for the Lions. They start off with the 49ers. Jeez Louise, that's a real tough game to open up at, and that will be a loss. Then they go and face the Green Bay Packers on Monday Night Football. Dan Campbell, you better make sure you're ready for the spotlight, because this is your first real chance on national TV to see what you're made of. Hopefully you don't blow it. We think he does. They start 0-2. Then they go and face the Ravens, another real tough opponent. Can't give them a win there. It's Lamar Jackson against a Dan Campbell defense. I'm giving it to Lamar Jackson. Then they go and face the Bears. And this is a potential game that they can maybe win, a nice division opponent, but I don't see them winning. I really don't even see them splitting their season series. Hopefully Justin Fields is playing by this time, week 4. Hopefully, we still don't know. But I can't even give the Lions a split against the Bears. I don't see that. Then they go and face the Vikings, another division opponent that I really don't even see them splitting against. I mean, this Vikings offense, I'm taking Kirk Cousins over Jared Goff as of this moment. Dalvin Cook over DeAndre Swift, obviously. The wide receivers all day and tomorrow, Justin Jefferson and Adam Thielen. I mean, Dan Campbell is really going to have his work cut out for him here the first 4 weeks. 49ers, Packers, Ravens, Bears, Vikings. First 5 weeks, geez Louise. Get it done. We don't think you can. They start 0-5. Then they go and face the Bengals. This is a winnable game for them. Do I think they go out and win it? No, but I'm going to classify it as a win here. This is a winnable game for the Lions. They are at home. The Bengals are nothing special in themselves. And if Dan Campbell can put a serviceable game plan in place here for a home game, they can win the game. So I will give the Lions a win here against the Bengals. But then it gets hard again. They go and face the Rams. Can't give them a win there. They can beat the Lions or the Eagles here the following week. I'm not going to give them a win, but this is a winnable game for them. We're kind of holding the threshold kind of like 60%. Do we see the Lions beating the Eagles kind of 60%? We don't think so. This is potentially kind of like 50-50, maybe 48% Lions, 52% chance that the Eagles win this game. It should be decent, winnable. I'm not going to quite count it. Then they're on the bye. Thankfully, thank God, you got to regroup. But then they have to come out and face the Steelers. That defense is going to eat the Lions alive. Not going to give them a win there. Then they face the Browns. Baker Mayfield and Kevin Stefanski, they will get it done. The offense for this Browns team is going to be very, very good this season, folks. Quote me on this. I do not care. This Browns offense, I'm going to say top 5. Top 5 Browns offense. Watch out for them. Then they face the Bears again. Like I said, I'm not going to have them split against the Bears in their season series. Then they face the Vikings. I can't even see them splitting their season series against the Vikings. Then they face the Broncos. A potential winnable game here, but it's in Denver late in the season. I'm going to go the Denver Broncos win it. Then they face the Cardinals. No chance at that game. They face the Falcons. A winnable game, but it's in Atlanta. I don't see them winning. Then they have the Seahawks and the Packers in their last two games. So I don't see them really doing anything. There is one good winnable game where they can truly secure one victory, and that's the Bengals. If we're looking for a second win, it has to come against the Eagles. If we're looking for a third win, it kind of has to come against the Falcons or the Broncos. And then if we're looking for a fifth win, so we'll give them a win against the Broncos and the Falcons, but then we're still at four. If we're looking for a fifth win to bet the over 4.5 wins, it has to be one of the division opponents of the Vikings or the Bears. They have to split in one of those games, and that would give us the five. I don't think that is likely to happen for all those things to happen. For them to split against the Bears or the Vikings, and to beat the Falcons, and to beat the Bengals, and to beat the, hang on, let me get their schedule up, and to beat the Broncos, the Falcons, and one of the Vikings, and then the Eagles or the Bears. I don't see all that happening, so we are going to bet the under 4.5 wins here. I just cannot find those five games. I can't. I don't see that happening. I don't buy into Dan Campbell. I buy into Jared Goff more than I buy into Dan Campbell. But at the end of the day, Dan Campbell's their head coach. He's the one that sets the kind of tempo in the locker room, in the game. He's the one that's supposed to bring the motivation, and I don't think anybody buys into it. We saw Jared Goff perform not great with Sean McVay. I'm taking Sean McVay over Dan Campbell any day and every single day of the week. Absolutely. And Sean McVay couldn't make Jared Goff work. I'm supposed to believe Dan Campbell's supposed to? Not buying into this Lions team under 4.5 wins.